because this Friday, we can play the league championship game with you. Mr. Troy Bolton's to infinity and beyond.
Hallelujah!
So right to be here.
Listen up for the very first scoring announcements of the brand new year. This is Jack Scott, the Velvet Fog of East High, with homeroom 411 on what's going down and coming up this week. The Science Decathlon finals are on Friday. See Taylor, Learning Curve, McKessie for more skinny on the hooey. During Freebird, the Science Club will meet in room 213, then switch from midway with the AB Club in room 312, then switch next two half sessions and reverse alternator schedules for the second half of the winter quarter. Skydiving Club will meet in room 3 o'clock p.m. on the roof deck, and the first day Club will be waiting for them down below. All for now, please.
Thank you.
Attention, custodial staff. A nauseous freshman just shared his pancakes all over the third floor corridor, so we're talking major spewage, folks. Sorry, guys, this just in. Please remember to sign up for the school musical Juliet and Romeo by Red Hot composer babe Kelsey Nielsen. Until later, this is Jack Scott, the Velvet Fog of East High.
Just keep your head in the game.
Come on, just keep your
love to see her. Oh, wait a minute, the trouble plays. Wait a minute, get my head in the game. Wait a minute, get my head in the game. Wait a minute, wait a minute. Get my head in the game.
You have 2 minutes to solve this relationship between energy and principal quantum number equation. Class, give it your best shot.
So it seemed like you were Troy Bolton.
Not really. I just asked him for directions.
Troy doesn't usually interact with the new students.
Why not?
He's such a bully. Always picking on the smaller kids. And it's pretty much basketball 24/7.
Cool. He hates math and chemistry. Don't get him started on chemistry. I don't think he's opened a book since Sally, Dick, and Jane says he didn't get it. Typical jock, right?
Nice.
And he's a meat eater with a flatulence problem. Ask anybody. Mr. Tenney?
Yes, Gabriella?
Oh, I'm sorry. I think it should be 10 to the negative 18th power.
10 to the negative 18th power? Well, that's quite impossible. Well, Miss Montez, I stand corrected. I am very impressed, and welcome aboard.
Did you know Troy Bolton spent a year in juvenile hall? Something to do with cats and lawnmowers.
Be gone, you have no power here.
Whatever.
Well, I'm impressed. You're a genius. Wait, it's just an equation.
Ryan, it's me. I thought Miss Darvis took your phone away. What? We always carry a spare. In case our agent calls.
Look, our science decathlon team has a big regional match on Friday.
We've never won it before, but with you on our side, we might actually stand a chance.
Thanks, but I'll pass for now. I just want to get to know the school.
Well, you probably should think about it.
Promise.
Troy Bolt was looking at our audition list again.
Again? He was hanging out with that Montez hag this morning, and they were both looking at the list. There's something freaky about her. Did you Google her like I asked?
Yeah, it's like she has an extra brain or something. Why is she so interested in our musical?
She's interested in Troy Barkboy. I need you to plant those printouts in Taylor's locker ASAP, okay?
No problemo, boss. Why am I doing that?
Look, there's no harm in making certain that Gabrielle is welcomed in the school activities that are appropriate for her. You know, the ones that keep her far away from Troy Bolton.
Kiss today goodbye and point me towards detention. So all you evildoers better get your butts to the theater immediately or face the wrath of Darvis the Merciless. This is Jack Scott signing off.
Yes, my brave detention menagerie. We thespians often use animals to build the characters we play. Be the bear, be the ostrich, be the monkey. Chum, chum, chum now, explore. Oh, wait, wait, wait. Ryan, do you want to be an ostrich?
Totally.
Ryan.
No, it's okay. Ostriches are cool, I guess.
For Sharpay, maybe. But what about you?
Me?
Yes. Unless you want to live the rest of your life in the shadow of your sister's ostrich.
The answer is yes. Huh? I'm so glad you changed your mind about the science decathlon. With credentials like these, we'll win that title for sure. Didn't you put them in my locker? Of course not. Well, we'd love to have you on the team. We meet almost every day after school. Please? I don't know. I really need to catch up on the curriculum here before I even think about joining any clubs.
But what a perfect way to get caught up. Meeting with the smartest kids in school. What a generous offer, Taylor!
Look, we've never ever won the science decathlon. You could be our answered prayer!
When you have lunch with us, you'll see. don't you think being in a musical would be fun, like, even just a tiny bit?
You're a hoop student, not a musical singer.
Hey, I'm not talking about me.
Good. But you can't expect the rest of us to be off hoops in the game when you're up somewhere singing in leotards.
Wait, nobody said anything about leotards.
Not yet, my friend, but you just wait.
Lovely work, all of you. James, I had no idea. An earthworm could have such depth, such pain. Now, let's gather in a circle for our last little exposure to the magic that is theater. This is called Ball of Noise. The idea is to pass around an invisible ball while making some sort of sound to go with it. Once passed to the next person, the ball can land in any part of the body. You are limited only by your own imaginations. I'll start.
Thank you. who's beside me.
I admire your plea, but not as much as I admire the shoe.
Watch the bulletin board for callbacks.
Don't
be discouraged. The drama club doesn't just need performers. It needs fans too. Buy tickets.
Sorry, you blasted. Anyway, I mean, if you do the part with that particular song, I was hoping you'd...
If we do the part? Kelsey. Kelsey, darling. I've been in 17 school productions. And let's see, how many have you written?
This would be the first.
Which tells us that?
I should write you more solos?
It tells us that you do not offer direction, suggestion, or commentary. And that you should be thankful that Ryan and I are here to lift your music program out of its current obscurity. Are we clear?
Yes, ma'am. I'm Sharpay.
Nice talking to you. Love your glasses. Hey! You decide to sign up?
No way. I came to give you, like, moral support. You are auditioning, right?
No. Your friends don't know you're here, do they?
Right.
You're not afraid, are you?
Me? Absolutely not. I'm the one who's used to all the attention, remember? You're the one who's afraid, not me.
I'm not afraid.
R2.
Am not.
R2.
Am not.
R2.
Am not. Am not. Am not.
Oh, yeah? Prove it. Go up there and show them what you've got. Don't worry. I'll be right here.
I'd like to audition, Miss Darvis.
I'm so sorry, my dear, but timing means everything in the world of the theater.
But I...
There's simply no one for you to audition with.
Miss Darvis, I'm here to audition.
Troy Bolton. Where's your sport posse, or whatever it's called?
Team. Actually, I'm here alone.
Yes. Well, I treat these shows just as seriously as your father treats his basketball practices. I called for the parts of Juliet and Romeo, and no one responded. You're out of luck, Jack.
Troy. You wrote that song Ryan and Shine just sing, right?
Uh-huh.
And the whole show?
Uh-huh.
It's awesome. How long did it take you to write?
About 2 years. I get up at 5 every day before school, and I'm still working on the finale.
That's awesome. That's really dedicated. So why are you afraid of Sharpay? It's your show.
It is?
Hello? Thank you.
Isn't the author of a musical, like, playmaker in basketball?
Playmaker?
The person who makes everyone else look good. You're the playmaker, Kelsey.
I am? Do you want to hear the way that song was supposed to sound? It starts off quiet. Go ahead. You first.
To believe that I couldn't see.
Nice. Keep going.
Always there beside me.
Now you.
But I was alone, with no one to hold.
Now together.
But you were always there beside me. This feeling's like no other. I want you to know.
Just say the first thing that comes to mind. How does it feel?
like I'm flying, you know? Like I'm soaring through the sky, like a bird or something.
Anything's possible in the theater, Troy. You can reach any star, but you have to allow yourself to risk. Oh, you can open your eyes now, Troy. We're not doing the miracle worker, you know.
You two are so amazing. Like, it's exactly what I heard in my head.
Thanks, Kelsey.
Bolton, Montez, you've got yourselves your callback. Kelsey, finish the finale and work on it with them.
If you want to rehearse, I'm usually in the music room during free period and after school, and sometimes even during biology class. Just call me on my cell phone and I'm there. Or, if it's easier, I can give you a wake-up call and come over with my accordion. It's mobile.
Thank you. called for.
Tables in the school cafeteria. Clicks have gone wild with an unprecedented response to Troy Bolton's callback to the school musical. One skater dude was even seen mixing in with the school band string section. Oh, the humanity. The humanity.
Unless we lose.
Must be tricky being the coach's son.
My parents' friends are always saying, your son's the basketball guy. You must be so proud. Sometimes I don't want to be just the basketball guy. I want to be, me.
I saw how you treated Kelsey at the audition the other day. Do your friends know that part of you?
I'm kidding. To them, I'm the playmaker.
Then they don't know enough about you, Troy. Waymaker. That's such an odd phrase.
How about that Pythagorean theorem? Totally whack.
I think you mean Pythagorean.
Right, totally whack.
At my other schools, I was just the freaky math girl. That's all they thought I was. Always pointing at me and laughing behind my back. They made me feel like I was a freak, and I hated it. That's kind of why I want to keep a low profile here, you know?
But you can't let people stop you from doing what you want to do. I mean, you are what you do, right? Kinda.
That's easy for you to say. You're the big basketball star. You love the spotlight. I'm a lot happier curling up with a good book.
I think.
No?
Maybe.
Well, maybe. I don't know. Remember in kindergarten? You'd be an idiot. Know nothing about them. Then 10 seconds later, you were best friends just because you didn't have to be anything but yourself?
Yeah.
Singing with you felt like that. Like safe, you know?
I never thought about singing, that's for sure. But when I sing with you, it's like anything is possible.
So you really want to do the callbacks? Oh, yeah. I mean, I didn't really want to do the callbacks either.
No, I'm in.
Really?
Hey, just call me Freaky Callbacks Boy.
You're a cool guy, Troy. But not for the reasons your friends think.
You never know what you're gonna feel. You never see it coming, suddenly it's real.
Oh, it never even crossed my mind that I could ever hope to find someone like you. Oh, things change when you don't expect them to.
Thank you.
Hey, Sharpay, now that Troy's gonna be in your show.
Troy Bolton is not in my show.
Okay, well, how'd you like the cake I made for you?
It doesn't go with my sweater.
That's funny. Do you want to come see me play ball sometime?
I'd rather suck the mucus from a dog's nostrils until its skull caved in.
That doesn't sound very appetizing. Would you prefer a nice creme brulee, tartufo, tiramisu? Tiramisu? Why do you say that? Oh my gosh.
Save Troy and Gabriella for themselves.
So what you're saying is the individual must be sacrificed for the good of the whole? That's so very cool, Marx. Works for me.
We'll get Troy in the locker room. You now have Gabriella in the lab at exactly 1600 hours.
Whatever. Just work him until he...
Troy Bolton's my best friend. I'd have to push all his buttons. And remember, the line of communication is crucial to the successful deployment of this covert operation.
Wow. I'm impressed. I didn't know you could say that many syllables together in one sentence.
Thanks. I've worked on it all night. My watch says 1300 hours. Mountain Standard Time. Are we synchronized?
Save it for Charlie's Angels, Chad. Au revoir, mon ami.
I love when you speak German.
Danke schön. Something isn't right. The jocks and the brainiacs mingling in the study hall.
The jocks already rule most of the school, but if they get Troy Bolton in the musical, then they conquered the entire student body.
And if the brainiacs get Gabriella hooked up with Troy Bolton, then the science club goes from drool to cool. And Troy will be hers forever. Ryan, we need to save our show from those who don't know the difference between a Tony Award and Tony Hawk.
But how?
Jarvis, I have a plan.
Lucy?
I'll tell Jarvis that Troy is that. Want to sabotage the auditions because she gave him detention.
She's never going to believe that.
Oh, she'll believe anything I tell her, because I'm the president of Drama Club.
Yeah, but the president's not supposed to lie, Sharpay.
Yeah, and the vice president's supposed to smile. Now zip it and do what I tell him to. All right, now come on.
I'm not playing.
Some very reliable sources
told me all about your little plot to humiliate me and the drama club. And I am telling you, it ain't gonna fly.
Save the speeches for the stage.
If you and your all-star son are planning some sort of practical joke in my chapel of the arts...
Troy doesn't even sing!
I guess you don't know your own son as well as you think you do. Nevertheless, I will not allow Juliet and Romeo to be made into a farce.
Juliet and Romeo?
See, I knew it. Very well, Bolton. If Troy is actually serious about auditioning, he's going to have to prove it. I will not allow either one of you to make fools out of the drama club.
You don't need my help for that.
And you, Mr. I'm soaring, I'm flying?
Hi, Miss Darvis.
I thought you were genuine, Troy. Wrong again, I guess.
What was that all about?
I don't know, Bolton. Something you want to tell me? Something about singing?
Just, you know.
No, I don't know. But what I do know is that Darvis the Deranged was just in here chewing my head off because she thinks you're plotting something against her.
I was just helping someone audition. That's all. It's nothing.
You're right, it's nothing. In case you've forgotten, we have our biggest game of the year coming up in 2 days. You're the team captain. Don't let your teammates down.
I'm just gonna stay and work on my free throws.
Yeah? Well, that's the least you can do, considering you've been late for practice. Twice!
Wow! So this is your real stage?
I guess you could call it that. Or just a smelly gym. Oh, don't tell me you're good at hoops, too.
Yeah, I am. Did you know I scored 41 points in a league championship once?
Oh, no way.
Yeah. The same day I invented the microwave and the iPad. I've been rehearsing with Kelsey.
I know, me too. I was late for practice again today, so if I get kicked off the team, it's on your conscience.
Hey! I just wanted to-
Gabriella, chill.
Excuse me, miss. This is the closed practice.
The practice is over.
Not until the last player leaves, Bolton. Team rules.
I'm sorry, sir.
Dad, this is Gabriella Montez.
Oh, your little detention buddy.
Gabriella, Taylor needs you up in the lab right away.
Hip-hop-a-ray.
See you later, Troy. Nice to meet you, Coach Bolton.
Goodbye.
Detention was my fault, not hers.
Now get it, Bolton. You haven't missed practice in 3 years. That girl shows up, and you're late twice.
That girl's name is Gabriella, and she's very nice.
Helping you miss practice is not very nice. Not in my book. Or your teams.
She's not a problem. She's just a girl.
But you're not just a guy. You're the team captain. What you do impacts not just the whole school, but the entire state. Without you completely focused, we don't stand a chance on Friday. Championship games don't come along every day. They're something special.
Yeah? Well, a lot of things are special.
You blow this chance, Bolton, you're gonna regret it for the rest of your life.
You mean like you?
You're a playmaker, Bolton. Not a singer.
Did you ever think that maybe I could be both? And my name is Troy, Dad, not Bolton.
Thank you.
Spider, build a tree.
Harriet, something.
Sam, slam a jam in that letter. Wildcat legends won championships by word about Brainiac chicks or auditioning for musicals?
Do you think these paradigms of education and accomplishment concern themselves with not auditioning for musicals? I don't know. Maybe so.
Miss last match for the 1981 championship game. Do it for him, Troy. Get the championship that he always dreamed of.
Heartbreak Bolt. Another lost cause, bonehead, basketball and moronic jock. But you, you're the future of the nation.
Believe that miracles can happen.
should just wear. It's a classic. And besides, why do we always have to do what you say?
Maybe because I know what I'm doing. I'm not taking any chances. That one's mine. I was born to play it.
Somebody in this room ought to chill out, sister. And it ain't me. Look, we'll get the parts we want. We always do.
I'm not talking about my role in the play, Ryan. I'm talking about my role in, like, the school. I'm not a jock. I'm not a brainiac. I'm a star. That's my role. And if they take it away from me, then who am I?
Well, you can just be Sharpay. That's not so bad, is it?
Are you brain dead? No one's gonna like me if I'm just Sharpay. But on stage, I can be Juliet. I can be Annie Oakley. I can be anyone I want to be. Not just dumb old Sharpay. I need something to make me fabulous, Ryan. I mean, come on. They named me after a flabby dog.
Look. We've had the leads every year since birth. If we get them again, great. If not, we'll still be fabulous.
But Troy, in that thing!
Look, maybe Troy would like you better if you're just yourself for once.
Excuse me, Dr. Fell, but what do you know? You're just a kid.
I'm only 8 minutes younger than you.
Yeah, well, those are 8 important minutes.
Oh, I didn't know you guys were in here.
Hey, Troy, did you come to ask if I'd switch partners with you? The answer is yes. Right, fine.
Sharpay?
No. Have you guys seen Gabriella? I really need to talk to her.
Who?
Oh, forget it.
Hey, the last time I saw her, she was in the theater, like, 10 minutes ago.
Thanks, Ryan. You're all right.
How could you stab me in the back like that? Help me, the enemy?
I stabbed you in the back?
Well, at least you admit it. Now take it from the top and lose those jazz wares.
Shut them up. The guy you met on vacation is way more mean than the guy who said those stupid things.
Troy, the whole singing thing is making the school crazy. You said it yourself. Everyone's treating you different because of it.
Maybe that's because I don't want to be just a basketball guy anymore. Gabriella, when I look into your eyes, I know I can be anyone I want to be because you don't look at me and place all these limits on me.
What, your dad?
This isn't about my dad. This is about me, about how I feel. I didn't let the team down, the team let me down. I'm gonna say, what about you?
I don't know, Troy.
It feels so right to be here with you. And now looking in your eyes, I feel in my heart. Start of something new.
I'm not afraid to
we have to sell, we have to tell our so-called friends.
Yeah, we have to tell them that we're going to be the callbacks, after all.
Well, let's move it already for Brenda's daylight!
But wait, it looks like we have a late-breaking Wildcat news flash. The callbacks for Juliet and Romeo have been moved up to tomorrow at 3 p.m. But wait, Miss Darvis, you can't. That's the same time as... Sorry, Troy, this is Jack Scott. Over and out.
What?
How can they do this? It's not fair. How can you be the science decathlon?
Win the championship.
And audition for my show.
We can't.
Well, it's clear you have no choice.
There's only one thing you can do. No.
Maybe next year, right?
Audition for the musical.
What? But what about the team?
I thought you wanted to win the decathlon. So we come in second. That's no disgrace.
Win or lose, we're teammates. That's what we're all about. Even if you turn to be the worst singer in the world, which you might be, because we haven't actually heard you sing.
He's fantastic. They both are.
What we did was so wrong. We just want you to know we're going to be there cheering for the both of you. In spirit, anyway.
Yeah, Cap. Singing is something you really want to do. We should be boosting you up, not tearing you down.
A leap that I couldn't see. You were always there beside me. Sorry about the callbacks, Gabriella. Good luck at the big game, Troy. But I was alone with no one to hold.
I am so sorry. Well, we've made our decision.
I'll be there for the team, Taylor.
I'll be there for the guys. It's just a musical anyways.
Just a musical? You know what he means. We can't be selfish. Not when our friends are depending on us. Right, Troy?
Right. But you can't.
But you can't.
But we can. See you guys later. Come on, yep. We can't let them do it.
Yeah, the team deferred and all that.
We need to find a way from the new boat.
Team huddle.
Hey, you spoke Jar.
I'm good with foreign languages, remember?
Down in split second.
Jack Scott can help us. He's announcing in the game.
It's impossible.
Leave it to me. I can do anything on my laptop.
Go Wildcats on three. One, two, three, go!
Go Wildcats!
Yesterday, we all were on our own boat. We didn't really know.
That we will love and bring something to the table to help the other
go. Now's the chance to take a new direction.
See through other eyes.
See through other eyes. To make a new connection. Hey, Miss Darkus, good luck at callbacks today.
A doggone?
Chad! Spelling! Wait a minute.
Go drama!
Fasten your seatbelts, kiddies. It's going to be a bumpy ride.
Calling all Wildcats. Following events are all starting immediately. Science and Capitalism is in the second floor lab. The auditions for Juliet and Romeo are in the theater, and the league basketball championship game is in the gym. Wildcats rule, baby. And the game is just about to begin. It's the Red Hot East High Wildcats safety board, led by team captain Troy Bolton.
You have exactly 5 minutes to solve this equation. Ready, set, and...
Ladies and gentlemen, let the callbacks begin.
You can do it, Gabriella, focus!
I warned you once, Miss McKenzie.
Gabriella, you Well, it would seem you are right, Sharpay.
See?
Unfortunately, I do.
But you have to give them a chance. They've been practicing all week, and they're really, really good. What you're always talking about, like reaching for the stars, that's what they're doing. Please, just two more minutes, I'll go look for them.
I'm sorry, Kelsey, but just like in theater, our lives are defined by our choices. Troy and Gabriella have clearly chosen not to audition. Congratulations to all. The cast list will be posted.
Wait, Miss Disposaris, we're here.
Wait just a minute.
I called your names twice. Where were you?
Please, just this one time.
Rules are rules, Miss Montez.
Miss Darvis, please, just give us this chance, just this once.
A chance for what, Troy? To make a joke out of something that your fellow classmates who came to audition and I hold so dearly?
But Miss Darvis, I came because I want to give it my best shot.
Please, we only have a few minutes until the lights come back on.
What's this? A full house?
As the president of drama club, I have to put my foot down. Non-preferential treatment. Those are your words, not mine.
Miss Darvis, Troy wasn't trying to ruin your callbacks. Sharpay just lied to you because she was afraid she wasn't gonna get the part.
Shut up!
Is this true? Did you abuse the presidential privilege and knowingly lie to me?
I didn't lie. I improvised. A little.
We'll talk about this later, Miss Evans. Right now, off the stage.
But I...
Off the stage!
The stage is yours, Miss Darvis.
Troy, Gabriella, you may start your callback.
But we don't have a pianist.
He'll sing without music.
Oh, no, you won't. Pianist here, Miss Darvis. You really don't want to do that.
Oh, yes, I really do.
Ready on stage.
Now that's showbiz.
I can't do it, Troy. It was so much easier when it was just you and me.
Then pretend like it is just you and me. Just like kindergarten, remember? I'll be right here.
Star in heaven that we can reach.
Jarvis about Lee. All's well that ends well, right?
Right. I guess I'm going to be playing the ugly nurse.
Unless you can't go on that is.
So, right away.
Huh?
In theater, that'd be
okay. Hey, Sharpay. Don't mention it to anyone. Ever.
Sorry to take part of it.
Join the club.
But I still think you're fantastic.
You too? I mean, like, really?
Like, really, really.
So, is that crumpy lady from this scene? Just like kindergarten, right?
Only better.
Time to celebrate. Your son sure can shoot the hoops.
Hey, he's not too bad at singing either.
I wonder where he gets it from.
Son!
No.
Ah!
Oh, really?
We wouldn't have anything close to what we do. So thank you so much. Thank you all very much for coming out. It was great to see all of you. And unless anyone else has anything to say, on down the line.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Maria Keller.